told you over the weekend, my wife and I were in Jamestown for there's the opening of this comedy center that is happening in Jamestown. But every year there is a huge festival, and it's an I Love Lucy festival. And there are museums there. This is the hometown, the childhood home town of Lucille Ball. And the actual home that she grew up in is right near Jamestown. It's been purchased, restored. You can tour the home. And it's owned by a woman and her husband who are a huge Lucy fans and did an amazing job of restoring this place. Mary Rappaport is on the line right now. Good morning, Mary.
Good morning.
Well, what a weekend in Jamestown.
It was a crazy weekend in Jamestown. We had the grand opening of the National Comedy Center and the annual Lucy Festival. And, of course, lots of people coming to 59 Lucy Lane, which is Lucy's childhood home.
So we'll post this later on, but I took a tour of the house. And, of course, all of the memorabilia. If you're looking for Lucy memorabilia, the website, 59lucylane.com, is the place to go because you have everything you could possibly think of. Speaking of everything you can think of, you have everything. You guys actually, so there's a museum that you funded and created, and you loaded it with all sorts of your own memorabilia plus the actual sets from the Lucy show.
Yes, and they are fabulous to see. It's just like walking into the TV from years ago. It's fun.
Yeah. I have to say my wife is a huge Lucy fan. She began crying when we walked into the,
are you serious?
And came around the corner and she saw the set and she began to cry. It's pretty wild, huh?
So, it is that realistic. You just have to come, you have to see it. You stand there and stare because you just can't believe that it's there. It's right in front of you.
Yeah. The actual set. Now, tell me, Mary, if you could, the story about the house. So this was the childhood home of Lucille Ball, and it's a modest house, but very large by really when you think about the standards of back then and what houses are like. But you came in and people had made updates. There was a brand new kitchen put in, and you went to great lengths to bring it back to where it was when Lucy was a child.
We did. The house was in really bad shape when we got it. A lot of leaks. A lot of things falling apart, but we took a year and put it back to the way it would have looked in about 1920 when Lucy lived there with her family.
Yeah. Right down to the explain how you were able to go back to the wallpaper and actually you basically took an old way of creating wallpaper and you went back and had that wallpaper recreated.
Yes, it's called rescreening. So they take... they take an old wallpaper book, and they actually take the print from it and rescreen it onto new paper, and they cut the edges off and put it on the walls.
Yeah. Really amazing. And then talk about some of the memorabilia that do you have any favorite pieces that you've collected over the years?
You know, I don't have favorite pieces. What I like to collect are the old Lucille Ball ads. The things that she advertised when her show was popular.
Got it. So if she was doing for Winston cigarettes or for something like that, that sort of those magazine ads, that stuff, or even electronic, that stuff that you really like.
Yeah, the real old stuff, 1950s, early 50s.
One more thing I want to talk about, because I think this is important. You have a big garage sale at the home every year during this festival, and you raise money for your causes. Can you tell how you became such a big Lucille Ball fan? Because you hadn't been a Lucille Ball fan your whole life.
Well, I've always loved Lucy, but I really became a fan after I had breast cancer 20 years ago. I was up all night watching Lucy. I decided to start researching Lucy a little bit. And fast forward, I now own her childhood home, and I'm a very big collector of Lucille Ball memorabilia.
Not everybody can say, I was such a fan, I bought her childhood home. But you can say that, which is really
cool.
You've
got to love Lucy to do that.
Yeah, there's no doubt. And listen, Jamestown is a town that, much like what we've seen here happen in Utica, the manufacturing has moved out. But and so there's a lot of buildings and a lot of vacancies. But this seems to be, between Lucille Ball and this Comedy Center, there's a bit of a resurgence. And it certainly was the place to be this past weekend.
It certainly was. There were just hundreds and hundreds of people coming in to see comedy. And that's what Lucille Ball is all about, comedy,
yeah.
Making you laugh.
Yeah. Well, listen, it's 59LucyLane.com is the website. That is now the street address. Here's a question. What was the street address? I can't imagine it was always Lucy Lane. What was the street address when she lived on it?
It was East Street.
East Street. So 59 East.
Eighth,
as in the number 8. 8th Street.
As in the number 8, yeah.
Well, the next time you're on Jeopardy, that could pop up. You never know. All right, Mary, thank you for everything, and thanks for taking the time this morning. We really appreciate it.
Thanks, Bill.
All right. The website, again, is 59LucyLane.com. Pretty cool.
So your wife got emotional about this.
Oh,
huh?
It was. I'm like, what are you doing? I'm emotional. I don't know. But she's a huge, my wife is a huge Lucille Ball fan. So, and those sets were the sets. And from each of the shows, there was one set that was their Hollywood set. And you could see there was a little bar in the background, the window overlooking. That was one of the sets for one of the shows. The kitchen, the nursery, all this stuff. If you ever watched most of it in black and white, the I Love Lucy show or the Lucy show, it's all right there in Jamestown.
Well, of course, the iconic living room scene. That's where everything happens.
I got to tell you, it is not a rundown. I've gone to these things before, and you go to a place, and it's like completely, it's been around forever, and it's kind of run down. These museums are beautiful, including the Comedy Museum, which is completely brand new. But I have to say, if you're, it's a 5-hour drive from here, be a pretty cool day trip. But you can certainly get on to her website, 59LucyLane.com, pretty easily.
Now, you've alluded to this a couple times this morning. You say, well, these are great, beautiful, you got to see them, well-kept, great shape. But I don't know if they're going to make it in Jamestown. What do you?
Well, I don't
it's
know.
Just so out of the way.
Thing. I don't know if the comedy thing. This comedy thing is enormous. It's like the size of the auditorium. It's huge, and next to it is an arena where they will bring in shows. But it's like going into the world's largest Hard Rock Cafe. But all of these electronic displays, all of these interactive things you can do. But again, it's in Jamestown, New York, and I hope it does work there because it could do a lot for the economy there. But pretty cool. It's just not easy to get there. So, you got to drive to Buffalo, yeah, and then drive south.